Welcome to a lesson on expected value. In this lesson, we will define expected value and also determine the expected value of an event. Expected value is an extremely useful probability concept to learn. It has many applications ranging from insurance policies to making financial decisions. It is also one thing that the casinos and government agencies that run gambling operations and lotteries hope most people won't learn. Expected value is the average gain or loss of an event if the procedure is repeated many times. We can compute the expected value by multiplying each outcome by the probability of that outcome, then adding up the products. So let's take a look at an example. You purchase one raffle ticket for a school fundraiser. The raffle ticket costs $5. The school is selling 10,000 tickets. One ticket will be randomly drawn and the winner will receive $10,000. Assume all tickets are sold, compute the expected value. So again, the expected value would be the expected outcome if you played this lottery over and over and over again. So the first thing we need to recognize is that there are 10,000 tickets and you only purchase one, therefore the probability of winning is 1/10,000th, which means the probability of losing would be 1 minus the probability of winning, or 9,999 divided by 10,000. Next, if you win, you don't really win $10,000. You'd actually have to subtract the cost of the ticket. So if you win, you actually win $9,995. And of course, if you lose, then you lose your $5 from purchasing the ticket. This is the information we need to find the expected value for this event. The expected value is going to be equal to the outcome of winning times the probability of winning plus the outcome of losing times the probability of losing. So again, if we win $9,995. The probability of this occurring is 1/10,000th. If we lose $5. The probability of this occurring is this probability here. So we find this product, and then find the sum to find the expected value. So $9,995 times 1/10,000th is equal to $0.9995, and then negative 5 times this probability is equal to negative $4.9995. Find the sum here, the result is negative 4 or negative $4. This is our expected value for this event, which means if you were to play this lottery time after time after time, the expected result would be that you would lose $4 each time. Let's take a look at a second example. A company estimates that 0.2% of their products will fail after the original warranty period, but within 2 years of the purchase, with a replacement cost of $250. If they offer a 2-year extended warranty for $28, what is the company's expected value of each warranty? So we're thinking of this as if we are the company, which means the probability of having to replace the product would be 0.2%, or as a decimal, 0.002, which means the probability of not having to replace the product would be 1 minus 0.002, or 0.998, or 99.8%. Next, the cost of replacement under warranty would not be $250. It would be the cost of the warranty minus the replacement cost. So notice how the true replacement cost for the company is $222. And again, this is negative because it's costing the company money. If they're gaining money, it would be positive, which means the revenue from non-replacement would be the $28 charged for each warranty. So one thing we do have to be careful about here is watching the signs when we're gathering this information. But this is the information we need in order to find the expected value for the company. The expected value is going to be equal to the replacement cost of negative $222 times the probability of replacing the item, which is a decimal is 0.002, plus the extra revenue from not having to replace the item, which is $28, the cost of the warranty, times the probability of not having to replace the product, which is a decimal would be 0.998. So if we find the sum of this product, we have the expected value for the company. So this first product comes out to -$0.444. The second product comes out to $27.944. Finding the sum here, notice how the result of the expected value is $27. Which means as they sell more and more warranties, the expected value or extra revenue would be $27 per warranty sold. I hope you found this lesson helpful.